Hey, welcome to the Dawson and Denise Show. I'm Dawson.
And I'm Denise.
And we want to talk about this issue. Don't let yourself go. Don't let yourself go.
Because obviously it's bothering him.
No, it's not bothering me. You know what I said, we were walking over here and I told you. I said, you know, sometimes you look at people. And people, I mean, you can come out of the house looking however you want to. But what I'm saying, every day, you got to come out looking throw it away. You got to come out with a house dress. You got to come out with rollers in your ear, run over shoes. Not saying you got to have the best. Some of the best clothes I have bought, because I have a sense, you know, a fashion sense at times. Mm-hmm. I've been at the Goodwill. Hey, go to the Goodwill.
But
style it up.
You don't but know all what I'm saying, people are
go
going
to the
through.
Salvation Army.
You
some
don't know
people,
what people are going through, and you just cannot assume just because of that one day you saw somebody in a house coat because maybe they were called on the phone and they had to rush out.
Okay, I can understand that. I can understand that. But what if you've been seeing this person countless of times, or these people, in a work setting,
okay,
or in a school setting, or they live in your neighborhood,
you're
and
right,
they just let themselves go?
Not
only by the way
you
dress,
go,
but by just eating everything. You cannot eat everything you want. And shut up, I know you can't go to bed. You cannot.
Why not?
Look.
What? If you're willing to exercise at all.
If you're willing to exercise at all, but if you can tell, your body is a temple. How you dress, well, this is how I feel. How I look, how I present myself is a resemblance of my creator. Is God broke down? Is he run over? Is he coming out looking helpless and hopeless in the midst of sorrow?
No, but
and
if, I'm not sure if he sees someone that, he'll give a helping hand.
He sure will. But the thing is, if you're proclaiming that you've got him and you know him, I don't think you have to come out looking hopeless and helpless. I think just the fate of me knowing that, okay, you know what, we're in the middle of a recession.
Well,
let me finish. We're in the middle of a recession.
Mm-hmm.
Things are getting bad. You know what? Instead of just going out and not with my shirt all wrinkled and, you know, all this stuff, my hair not, you know, shaved or, you know, my teeth messed up.
What if people don't have power to iron their clothes?
There is a lake right over there. If you can't take, see all that mess about, let me tell you something. People say, oh, well, you know, I'm homeless and all this kind of stuff. There's a lake out there. There are people who wake up every morning and do stuff like that. The
what
movie,
you mean, do stuff like at the lake?
No, they do stuff like take showers. They have bathrooms where people go shave who are homeless. You know what the cards you've been dealt in life.
Yes.
And you just have to deal with that. I'm sorry,
okay,
you do.
So you deal with you and let them deal with them.
She's some humanitarian,
not,
man.
Exactly,
she thinks, oh, my God.
I'm going to help everybody.
Well, in the process of trying to help everybody, they hurt you. So I just hope you're ready
they
for that.
They don't hurt me.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Hurt. Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
You can't save everybody.
I'm not trying to save them.
Yes,
I'm
you
just
are.
Trying
yes, you
to
are.
Help
yes,
them.
Yes, she's always trying to save people. And that's what I'm saying. People come outside, or people
for?
Look run over.
We're
and
not
then
here to help others.
We are here to help others who want to help themselves. God helps those who help themselves. That's not in the Bible, but I mean, there are parables that basically say that. Look at the man who had laid by the lake almost 35 years. God didn't go and heal him and touch him. God said, why have you been here 38 years? Or he's like, well, you know, nobody helped me to get into Bethsaida, the lake or the sea Bethsaida. So he said, take up your bed and walk. And immediately, even before he started walking, when he got up and took up his bed, his faith made him whole. He walked on the voice of God. So all I'm saying, that's just me being religious right there. But what I'm saying, don't let yourself go. Do not let yourself go. We people let themselves
and
go for so many
that,
things, man.
But like I said, I will ask you what happened to get to that state and what can I do to help you out of it.
Why are you acting like you ain't never seen nobody who has not just let themselves completely go?
I have.
What do you feel
instead of attacking me? But at the same time, you know what? I have, but I never really paid that much attention to it.
But that's what our show topic is today. So for the viewers who have let themselves go, tell them advice. Don't come here attacking me when you like there are no people in the world who let themselves go. People may be watching this. And of course, they may have been in a relationship. They may have had a loved one who died. They may have been this. And there is a period that you go through.
Yes.
But that is not supposed
like
to be your
before.
Permanency.
No,
that's
it's
not supposed to be life.
It's
you don't
not.
Just
we
let yourself
cry
go.
We say, cry me a river, build a bridge, and get over
that's
it.
That's right. Thank
but
you.
But on that
now
day,
you're speaking.
On that day when
now
you were crying,
speaking.
Maybe that was the day I saw you. So it wasn't
no,
time for you to build
no,
your bridge.
No,
yet.
No,
yes.
No. Okay, so you're getting a little far-fetched now. Come back
whatever.
Here. What I'm saying is people that you see on a daily basis, people who you know that just
well,
do
know
not let
like that.
Themselves go.
Everyone
yeah,
because
she lives in Scardale. She lives way on the opposite side of Miami by
whatever.
All the rich people
no,
who drive BMWs and Bentleys
is,
and Porsches. She don't know what the common folks, and then she come over here trying to act like she know
us. Yes, I do.
Whatever.
Yes, I
whatever.
I know I was born and raised.
Where?
Perrine, thank you very much.
Oh, yeah, so, whatever.
We done had our share of hard times, okay, and whatever. We got out of them. But we didn't knock each other down.
And who's saying we're knocking people down? All I'm saying is that if you let yourself go, you have just, that's your problem. I mean, there are plenty of people who lost loved ones. We passed by a funeral coming here today. That took me back.
You got choked.
Shut up, man.
So you want to talk about me trying to save everybody and be such a good whatever, but you were crying.
But what I thought about when I was looking at that funeral is I was like, man, you know what? We all going to have to face that one day with a loved one, and I have, and I thought about the loved ones that I lost. And what I said now, I was thinking in my mind, I'm like, they would want me to go on with life. They would want me to live.
Right.
All the crying, all the moping, all the feeling
won't
like the end of
back.
It won't bring them back. But there's a life out there that I got to live today.
And
I can't let myself go. And that's what
and
I'm saying.
In the midst of me living my life, I would love to touch as many people as I can. And that's just what I'm here to do. Sorry.
Yeah, you like to touch as many people as you can. Anyway.
So do you.
With my heart and with the hand of God, I sure do. But all I'm saying is, like, don't let yourself go. Look good. Feel good about yourself, man.
It's
I mean,
about,
if you're a big person or if you're a person who just don't...
Confidence.
It's all about confidence and knowing who you are, because some people feel like, oh, I'm a little overweight. I don't feel good about myself. Don't let yourself go that way, man. Feel
right.
good. I mean, I know some girls who are pretty healthy and they look good. Their confidence is attractive.
Exactly.
And then there are some girls who are attracted to guys who are, you know, whatever.
Confident.
Yeah, it's confidence. Confidence is key in everything. It's not about being selfish or you know, stuck up. It's just about being, you know, confident in you and who you are. That's the main thing. Yeah, so.
And if you feel confident coming out in your dress, your bedroom slippers, hey, slide on.
Slide on, yeah. Don't come outside looking messed up, man. Serious.
No, take pride in yourself.
Yeah, take pride in yourself, but still, I mean.
Take pride in yourself.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Don't let yourself go. Oprah even said that. Don't let yourself go. A lot of people say that.
No, you
can't
shouldn't.
Let yourself
you
go.
Shouldn't.
Oh, everybody going
but
out my life. I'm just going to eat everything. No way.
If you're comfortable in flip-flops, slip on.
Anyway, I'm Dawson.
And I'm Denise.
And you just watched another exciting edition of Dawson and Denise Show.
Slam dunk.
He's at the Airlines Arena. Go Heat. I know he is the Heat. Hey, we out of here. Take care. Peace.
You have a sticker on.
Where?
Again.
Oh,
I was trying to tell you that.
You know what, Taya.